start now with breaking news that we've been following all morning. Within the last couple of hours, we learned five people were shot at a New Year's Eve celebration in Uptown. Take a look at your screen right now. This is the scene just after midnight. Thousands gathered at one of the biggest celebrations in the Queen City. WCNC Charlotte's Destiny Richards is live now in Uptown. Destiny, you're hearing police now have a suspect in custody.
That's right, Kia. In the midst of everything that was going on last night, CMPD did confirm to us when all of this was happening that they did get one person in custody in connection to this shooting, but still a lot of questions just about what happened. Right now this morning, Uptown is completely clear. There's no CMPD presence right now, but it was definitely a chaotic scene just a couple of hours ago as people were trying to ring in the new year. Here's specifically what it looked like at the intersection of South Church Street and West Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. The shooting happened around 11:30 last night, according to CMPD. Investigators say someone shot into a crowd, striking five people. And again, police did say they took a person to custody after the shooting. There was a lot of confusion about what was going on as police put up caution tape and kept people away from Romare Bearden Park. We still don't know exactly what led to the shooting, but one person we spoke with believes that it was a younger crowd causing trouble.
We was coming out here trying to have fun. They should keep the high schoolers home because there's a lot of grown folks out here doing grown folks things. So I don't want to be running around because they can't, you know, be mature.
Now, the five people who were shot only sustained non-life-threatening injuries, so they are expected to survive. And like I said earlier, just a lot of questions surrounding what exactly happened. There was speculation about a fight that was going on near the bars and the celebration that was going on last night. There were people running, being chased by police, all sorts of stuff happening. So we will work throughout the day to try to get some details about what went on, but just know it is a clear scene early this morning here in Uptown. I'll send it back to the studio.
All right, Destiny, thanks, and stay safe out there. Now, we've had crews on the scene for the last several hours. Just minutes before the news broke, WCNC Charlotte's Austin Walker found himself in the middle of the action. Take a look at your screen now. So Austin was delivering his life report. You can see a man running right through his shot, trying to get away from police. Now, we're not sure why police were chasing after the man in the video, but we are working right now.
There's still a large police presence in the scene of some breaking news we've been following all morning in downtown L.A.
Yeah, that's where at least two people have been shot and killed at a New Year's Eve party. And NBC4's Bailey Miller is live, where she just heard from investigators. Bailey, what are they saying?
Just a moment ago, investigators did give us an update. Now, we know right now two people were killed. They did tell us eight people were transported to the hospital. So that's a little bit more than we had originally heard. So we know eight people have been transported to the hospital. That's the big update right now. Right now, they say they are in investigation mode. They were not able to confirm with us if they are looking for any suspects at this time as they still work to piece this together. Right now, let me show you the scene here. You can see still quite active as LAPD officers have blocked off these couple of streets here as they continue to work and piece together what happened. Now, we did hear from witnesses. Take a listen to what they had to say about this very scary scene.
It was like people were running, like it was just running, people falling. Like, it's just hard to see because it was just so graphic.
All right, so all of this happened just before 1 a.m. here at Porter and Olympic in downtown L.A. LAPD says five people were shot, two were pronounced dead at the scene, and the others were transported to the hospital. As we learned in that update, eight people were transported to the hospital with injuries. Some witnesses described that scary scene, as you heard, and as of right now, we're still working to learn about what kind of gathering this was. LAPD did update us saying that it was a warehouse gathering. We're not sure if this was a sort of illegal gathering or how many people were there at this time. I did ask LAPD investigators that. Right now, they say it's just so important because they're in that investigation mode, and they did talk about how complex this situation is for them to kind of piece together right now. But this is going to be blocked off for some time here in downtown LA as they continue to investigate. Reporting live here in downtown LA, I'm Bailey Miller. I'll send it back to you.
A new year begins, of course, with promises of new beginnings. But it appears that gun violence continues its pattern of hurting people and terrorizing neighborhoods right here in Marion County. In the first hour of the new year, first few hours of the new year, Metro Police now dealing with multiple shootings. WRTV's Nico Panisi live this morning with the latest on the ongoing investigation. And Nico, there are a lot of these investigations that are going on as we speak.
You're correct, Raphael. As you had mentioned, in just the first few hours of the new year, Metro Police officers with Metro Police here have confirmed at least 11 different incidents of gun violence across Indianapolis. Two people are dead and nine others are injured since 11:30 Sunday night. Now, let me show you a map of the different locations where these shootings were reported. IMPD says that the first person died from what is believed to be a self-inflicted injury. That happened on the west side at the 3500 block of Hollow Run Circle. Second person dead was shot and killed on Indy's north side. And here's what we know about that shooting. Captain Mark McCarty says around 1 a.m., police arrived at the 3100 block of Boulevard Place to find a van shot up with blood in the front seat area. They quickly found a man 20 or so yards away on the near side of the house with gunshot wounds. He was taken to the hospital in critical condition, where he later died. IMPD says this is the first homicide in Indianapolis for 2024. And across the city on the southwest side, IMPD is asking for the public's help in a shooting that left a man hospitalized overnight. Just a few feet away from a manger scene at the 5100 block of Sandy Forge Drive were clothes and bullet markers in the street. Captain McCarty says around 11:30 last night, police found a man in the street shot multiple times in the abdomen. He was taken to the hospital in critical condition. And as of right now, there are currently no suspects.
We need the public's help in this situation. Somebody knows something about what happened here. This is not an accidental shooting. There are a lot of shell casings here on the roadway.
And if anyone has any information about that shooting or any of the other shootings we're reporting to you tonight, or this morning, excuse me, they're asked to call Crime Stoppers at 317-262-TIPS. And as always, that call is an anonymous one. These are developing stories. WRTV will continue to update you on air and on web as we learn more from police. Reporting live, Nico Panisi, WRTV.
People were shot inside of a home in the first homicide of the new year in Chicago.
Glenn Marshall's live at University of Chicago Hospital, where the two victims are being treated. Good morning, Glenn.
Hey, good morning, guys. Now, those two victims are here at University of Chicago Hospital after they were shot inside of a home. Police are saying the bullets actually came through a window, killing another man. Now, this happened around 12:45 this morning inside of the home that sits near the corner of 70th and South Wabash in the Greater Grand Crossing neighborhood. Police are saying they were called to the home and found three victims suffering from gunshot wounds. A 53-year-old man was shot multiple times. He was pronounced dead at the scene. A 48-year-old woman was shot in the arm. She was taken here to U of C Hospital in fair condition. 49-year-old woman is also here at U of C Hospital after she was shot in the side of the head. She's listed in critical condition. Police believe the suspect's gunfire came through a window of that home. As of right now, Area 1 detectives, they are investigating this shooting, but so far no one has been placed in custody. For now, we're live outside of the University of Chicago Hospital. I'm Glenn Marshall, WGN News.
Rick Court, good evening to you both. Right now, there's no information on the number of suspects involved or why they opened fire on this group of five. The shooting happened around 12:30 this morning inside the parking lot of this strip mall at the corner of Crenshaw and Rosecrans. And even hours later, this entire shopping center is blocked off as police investigate. One person who lives in the area says he heard multiple gunshots and thought it could have been a New Year's Eve celebration. Listen to what he told us.
Yeah, then it started sounding like fireworks. And when I took my actual headphones off, it's like when you're in LA, you know the sequence of fireworks versus gunshots. You know what I mean? If it's going back to back, okay, it might be a little fireworks. But if it goes, stops, starts going again more rapidly, of course, you know it is gunshots. And with the police presence that you can see over coming towards that moment in time, it confirms it's automatically going to be a homicide or somebody got shot at or someone was shot or somebody died, unfortunately, like it was today.
here's some video taken early this morning at the crime scene. Witnesses say it's a popular spot for teenagers to hang out and congregate. All five victims were hospitalized in varying conditions. A woman ultimately died from her injuries. The victims were taken to Memorial Hospital, about a 5-minute drive from here. Footage appears to show officers cordoning off and canvassing parts of the hospital for evidence. We also spoke to the LA Sheriff's deputy on site today, who gave us a brief update about what happened.
The the victims were congregating here at the location, and shortly thereafter, gunfire erupted, and multiple victims were struck by the gunfire and subsequently transported to local hospitals where they were treated. And as I said earlier, unfortunately, one of them was pronounced dead.
Back out here live to give you an idea of just how large this crime scene is. About a half a mile of Rosecrans is currently closed to traffic as police investigate what happened here. About five large blocks, and we've seen detectives going door to door to various businesses in the area. I'm told they're looking for surveillance video, which would give them a better idea of the car that was involved. That's the very latest from Hawthorne. I'm Rachel Menatoff. Court Rick, back to you in the studio.